Okay, students, now we will discuss the complex number through this PPTs. So now see, in this session, what we are going to study. Now, if I ask you what is log base e of minus 1, so I know that the domain of log is a non-negative numbers, that is positive. So it is not defined in that domain. So clearly, it's a complex number, not defined. And is a complex number. One of its value is iota pi. What is the objective complex number definition? Equality of complex number, algebra of complex number, geometrical representation, conjugate of a complex number, properties of modulus and argument, equation involving variables and locus. Now this is what the Euler was supposed to solve. In this equation, we know that discriminant is negative, so no real roots. So then Euler, Linard introduce the new word, that is iota, that is root minus 1 is iota. Iota is the first letter of the Latin word imaginarius. Okay. Now the integral power of iota. Iota raised to 1 is 1, iota raised to 1. Sorry, iota raised to 0 is 1, and then accordingly you can see that the minimum power of iota that makes it 1 is 4. Iota raised to power minus 1 is 1 by iota, so we multiply and divide by minus iota, that is minus iota, like this. You can see the various powers. Suppose if you are asked to find this, what will we do? Open it like this, iota raised to 16, and this way. Then you can use 1 by iota is minus iota, and it is something like this, that is minus 7 iota raised to power 3, that is 343 iota. Now if p, q are 4 consecutive integer, then what is iota raised to p, iota raised to q, iota raised to r, the options are there. Now consecutive numbers, so what will we do? We have taken this q as p plus 1, r is p plus 2 and p plus 3. Now substitute here. Now see, what will be the answer? That is 0. Now again there is a problem, and you can see, watch on the screen. Then he is asking u of 27, so you can accordingly calculate. Now see, there you can see the relations. In fact, it become a finite GP, so we have used the GP formula. So this way you can calculate it. Now the complex number mathematical notation is z, a plus iota b, real part of z is a, imaginary part of z is b. So we can express, this is the standard form. Now you can identify real and imaginary part here. If a is 0, then z is purely real. If b is 0, z is purely imaginary. If a and b are 0, z is purely real as well as purely imaginary. Equality of complex number. Obviously, two complex numbers are equal if their real and imaginary parts are equal. A1 equal to A2 and B1 equal to B2. No, these are not equal. One of them must be greater than the other. No, the order or inequality is not defined for complex numbers. So please make sure we cannot use here inequality in the complex numbers. Find x and y. So what will we do here? Simply hint, that is simply compare real and imaginary part. You can see that easily, you can recognize. Obviously x and y you can calculate like this. I hope the problem part is clear to you. You can watch the solution. Addition will be done component wise. Closure, that is the sum of two complex number is complex number. Commutativity is hold. Again, associativity again holds true. Additive identity. Additive inverse. Again, same in the subtraction. Then the product. Commutative. Multiplicative identity is 1. And the multiplicative inverse of z is equal to like this. That is a minus iota b upon a square plus b square. Please do remember. again distributive is there, division. What you will do in the denominator, just use the conjugate part of it and multiply it. If one of the root of this equation is iota x square minus 2 into 1 plus iota plus is 2 minus iota, then other is sum of the roots. You calculated and you can easily calculate it, that is minus iota. We have used the concept of sum of the roots. Representation in the Argand plane. Now see, x-axis is a real axis and imaginary axis, and a plus iota b will be represented as a coordinate here. Modulus of z is nothing but distance from the origin. Argument or amplitude of z is the angle made by the complex number with the positive x-axis. Theta is nothing but, or you can say tan theta is b by a. You can easily calculate from the triangle, or theta equal to tan inverse b by a. And argument belongs to this interval minus pi to pi, that is semi-open closed interval, is known as the principal argument. Find theta, for theta belongs to 0 to pi by 2. Identify in which quadrant a comma b. Please, when we are finding this theta, please always find this theta as acute. That is why it is put inside the modulus. Now, these are the quadrant locations of the complex numbers. You can easily identify the locations like this. Then use the adjoining diagram to find it accordingly. Based on the quadrant, the argument is given. Now, see, the complex number which satisfies this equation is, now in such type of case, we take z as any complex number x plus iota y. Substitute in the given equation. Simplify it. Now, since the right hand side is 0, so comparing real and imaginary parts. Now, solving y plus 1 equal to 0, that gives y equal to minus 1, use in that equation. Now we can easily solve this, x is equal to minus 2. So this is the principal argument of this. Now see, clearly theta acute angle is pi by 3, third quadrant. Now this is nothing but theta minus y minus 2 pi by 3 is the answer. You can easily see. Conjugate of a complex number, it is nothing but reflection about x-axis, that is z bar a minus iota b. Image of z on x-axis, that is what we call. If z is root 3 plus iota by 2, then z conjugate is simply like this. If z equal to z conjugate, that is b is 0, z is purely real, that is z lies on x-axis. If this happen, what if z equal to minus z bar? You can easily see that it will be an imaginary number purely, and z lies on y-axis. These are some important observations. Argument of z bar is argument of a minus iota b is minus tan inverse b by a, that is minus argument of z. These are some, please, as I discussed that no order inequality, but modulus of a z is a real number, that is a number associated with every complex number, is that is real number is modulus. You can easily do the proof part, some triangle inequalities and some various inequalities, and some properties of argument, that is argument of z1 into z is argument of z1 plus argument, like this. Now conjugate of 1 upon 2, first express, please let me tell you, first express in the standard form, a plus iota b. So we multiply and divide by 2 minus iota. So we obtain like this. Square root of a complex number. Now see, root a plus iota b. Squaring on both sides. Comparing real and imaginary part. Now use this, is the standard identity. Find x square. Take positive value of x. Take value of y which satisfy this. Note the sign convention like this. Square root will be x plus iota y. other root will be minus x plus iota. Now let us consider one example. What we did, comparing real and imaginary part. Now since the product 2xy is negative, so therefore x and y are of opposite sign. Comparing, now we obtain the square root of the complex number like this. Now you can see this diagram, Cartesian system and the Argand diagram. Point x comma y is correspond to the complex number z. Locus of a point is the locus of a complex number point. In equation x and define shapes as circle, parabola. Equation in x variables define shapes as circle, parabola. Distance between this point is nothing but here modulus, that is like this. So these are some problems. This type of problem may be asked in JE, but if somebody is preparing for that, be ready for that. If z is a complex number, mod z plus 1 is equal to 2 times mod z minus, represents circle, hyperbola, ellipse, straight line. So you can see z is x plus iota y. Now use it. So these are some illustrative problems. So these are the problems for you. So please, guys, solve it. I am just sharing the solution, but use your own brain and accordingly you can solve them. Similarly, we have to find the, here we are using the triangle inequalities. Now some class exercise, you may please note down the questions and you may solve it. I'm just discussing the problem parts. Now it's in fact showing the problem, so you have to solve it by your own. See the problems part. See the another problem. There's again a famous problem, so you can see the way we have solved that. Again, it is a very good problem and it is a problem from exemplar. So this type of problem may be asked. You can square root of the complex number that we have discussed. Thank you everyone for cooperating with me.